Got to live for today, cause tomorrow ain't promised to me. Don't just want a piece, I want my whole destiny.
If you got it,
I'm gonna take it.
If you're in it,
you're coming with me.
Bench warmers,
get no playing time,
no sleeping
till I cross the line. I'm running.
Going on. Yeah, I know it's been a little minute since I made the last video. Just had to take a little break, you know, especially on the days where I definitely don't be thinking about pulling out the camera. And sometimes that happens for long periods of time, and then so much time goes by it doesn't even match up with the previous cuts of video that I already have. So I think the last video, according to YouTube, was 3 months ago. But right now I'm in Columbia, South Carolina. I was on home time. I just got a load today. Today is the 14th of October. Came up here to pick up a load. Well, I had to come up here and pick up an empty in Lexington, and then come over here to this Otis Spunkmeyer and pick up a load. It's currently 6:45 p.m. They just got done loading me. I'm just waiting on some paperwork real quick. Hopefully it don't take long. And I'm gonna be heading out to Denton, Texas. Due Friday afternoon. But for tonight, it's already late. I already planned on doing this anyway. I was just gonna come pick up this load and then drive back to my house and spend the night at home. I left all my stuff, my clothes, everything that I need. You know, I was already anticipating going back to the house, which I am. So that's about it for right now. Same old stuff been going on, man. Like I said, I was on home time. Had to put the truck, had to take the truck to Thermo King to get my APU fixed. My APU was actually out for a while. And kind of a struggle keeping the daggone batteries charged without the APU. So yeah, it's been a little rough dealing with that, but it's fixed now, so we back normal. But I guess I'll get with y'all in the morning when I head out towards Texas. Actually, Friday night. I think I hollered at y'all right after I left the house. But I'm up here in Texas. I already dropped the load off. Picking up over here at the Clorox plant, just 17 miles down the road, going to Colorado, Loveland, Colorado, to a Walmart, dropping hook. I don't know if you can tell, I'm pretty tired right now, man. They've been loading my trailer for a few hours now. I've been up since 5:30 this morning. Excuse me. It's currently 9:43 Central Time. Yeah, I'm ready to lay it down so I can give me some rest for my day tomorrow. I'm going to take 287 all the way out to Interstate 25, and then 25 north through Denver up to Loveland. Drop this off on Sunday. Yep, that is the plan. I'm actually about to go in here and see if they didn't forget about me or something, because when I did drop the trail off in the door, I guess they want you to bobtail over here, park over here, and whatever. I went in the back and laid down. I think she called me like 10 minutes later and was like, "Hey, your load ready." I was like, "What?" I went inside. She was like, asked me, was I in a certain door? I was like, "No, I'm in another door." She was like, "Oh, I didn't mean to call you." I was like, "All right." I don't know if she got the numbers mixed up or whatever. Maybe she lost my number to my door, but I don't know because I'm the only truck left here. It was like five of us here. Now it's just me, so I don't know. I'm about to go check on that right now. I'll get back with you because I'm ready to get to the truck stop. Hopefully my reserve spot is still open. I ain't got to get nobody kicked out because I'm ready to lay down, like I said. What's going on, people? Just checking in real quick before I go inside this Flying J, take me a shower. I'm in Lyman, Colorado. Dropping off tomorrow, dropping a hook at Walmart, of course. But anyway, just an update of what was going on. You know, I was sitting at the shipper last night, and I ended up being the only truck left there when I got up out of bed and looked around. So I waited, probably another 30, 40 minutes. And I decided I was going to go in and, you know, see if they forgot about me or something. But as soon as I went in, well, I didn't even go in. I think as soon as I got to the door, I put my hand on the door, that's when the lady called me from the office and told me my paperwork was ready. So that worked out good. But left there, went to the pilot up on Highway 287. Already had me a reserve book. So went there and went to sleep. Damn. But that's about it. I know when I was about to jump out the truck last night to go in, I noticed that Skunk Man was over there by the gate, like straight across from the truck. And it was dark, but I noticed that it was a skunk. It's kind of being cautious. I don't want to meet that fella. But anyway. Yeah, we just drove up 287 the whole way. Up through Oklahoma, up through Colorado. Most of y'all should be familiar with that route. So I'm on 70 now, but like I say, I got about 120 miles, about 2 hours worth of riding in the morning before I get to Walmart. And that'll be it for this load and see what's next. Alright. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, it's the next morning. It is 8:52 Mountain Time in Loveland, Colorado. I just arrived at the Walmart. Just waiting in line, ready to get to the front so they can tell me where to drop this trailer, get my empty, and then I'm out of here. Quick and easy. Alright. Dropping off my empty right now. Had to go around the building to get me, dropping off my loaded. You know what I'm talking about. I had to go around the other side of the building to get it empty. Might just stay here when I hook up to my empty. See if they go ahead and send me another load instead of leaving, going all the way back to that petrol on 25. I don't think they'll mind for a little while. Go get my lock off the back. What's going on? I'd have made it to Jessup, Maryland. Not that y'all knew I was heading this way, because I haven't pulled the phone out and recorded anything. But I actually picked my load up in Idaho. And the next day, as I'm riding across 80, I noticed that I didn't plan that load real well, so I couldn't make the Friday morning 8 a.m. appointment in Wayne, New Jersey to drop that off. So got together with my fleet manager. We ended up getting the load repowered, which I switched out with this team truck who had a very similar load that was coming out of Idaho but going to Laurel, Maryland. Appointment time on that Saturday morning at 8 a.m. So it's actually Friday, about 5:30 p.m. right now. I just made it to Jessup, Maryland. Sit here at the TA, you know, it's the only truck stop around here. And wait for in the morning, so I made that. The money equaled out, you know, what they paid me to drop off in Brooklyn, Iowa, to switch out with them, and then take their load and bring it the rest of the way. Was paying on the remainder of that load. Pretty much equals out to what I was making on the Wayne, New Jersey load anyway, so that worked out. I just had to wait another day later to deliver, which is fine. I don't mind. You know, 70 was running low. You know, it was the beginning of the work week, kinda, when I got the load, so didn't really want to take a 34, so we made it happen. But on the way, let's see, after I picked the load up from them, I drove on down to the Iowa 80 truck stop to that TA, and I ended up getting my oil changed, getting my annual DOT done, which the initial annual DOT test inspection failed because I had some problems going on my brake on the driver's side steer, which had to be fixed immediately, which, yeah, I went ahead and got that done. So obviously passed inspection after that, so no harm, no foul. Just glad that, you know, these things can be caught before tragedy happens. Whew. But anyway, that's all I got going on. And I guess I'll see y'all in the morning, so I say. All right. We're all done here. We've been delivered, we're empty. Move this truck out the way. See what's next. It's most likely gonna be the Nestle warehouse across the street, but we'll see. All right, what's going on? So, as I said, next load came in, of course, is the Nestle. I got lucky and I got a pickup time that was coming up pretty soon, which was 1 o'clock. You know, they only let you check in like 4 hours before. I got here a little after 11, checked in. My trailer's already ready. Dropping my empty, going to grab my loaded. And we heading to McDonald, Georgia. Till next time. It's empty. We at Atlanta Bonded Warehouse. Picking up a preloaded trailer. I dropped my ice cream off last night. Had a midnight appointment. That went pretty well. Stayed overnight at the receiver. We got up, come get this. It's already ready. But my appointment's not till 9 tonight. So we'll see what happens with that. It's right on the other side of the city in Athens. Well, I guess I'll go over there and see what's happening. They're gonna make me wait till 9 o'clock, which is fine. But that's what's going on at the moment. When I left the petrol yesterday morning in Kinley, I went by my house and spent the day at the house, and then left out last night to deliver my load. So that was a nice little stop off. Watched a little football. Got to meet my new niece and nephew. So, you know, now we continue on. I'm going to go find this trailer, get my paperwork, get up out of here. Oh, good morning, good morning. It is the morning of the 28th. Ooh, and I've been up since about a quarter after 12, driving from Evansville I don't even remember what state I was in. But I'm here in St. Joseph, Missouri, just north of Kansas City. Prime had my appointment set for 8 a.m. excuse me. Which I did make it here by then. But it doesn't matter because this place is first come, first serve. And apparently I'm number 6 on the list. And I've already been told that they're probably not going to get to me until about lunchtime. Now, I was offered a pre-plan, which picks up down the road from here at Ventura Foods. And the pickup time was at 9 a.m. That's not about to happen. So I messaged dispatch and told them the situation. So I probably lose that pre-plan. It was going back to Johnson City, Tennessee. Like 800 and some change for like $1,700. It was pretty all right low, but it doesn't seem I'm going to be able to get it unless they first come, first serve too. And then I can just go over there and get it, you know, whenever I'm done here and go get a washout. But I guess we'll see. I don't know how long this takes. They wanted me to go down the road to the some little public lot that they said they have trucks park at, and then they call us when they're ready for us to come back and unload. I don't know. I might just try to camp out here behind this other Prime truck that's waiting. Go back here and make me a little breakfast, man. Excuse me. That's the update for right now. Absolutely nothing going on. Seems like, well, actually, it's a good thing. Nothing real interesting happens in my trucking life. I like to keep it that way. So, yeah, I'll get back with y'all in a minute. What's going on? We are here in Cleveland, Tennessee at the Mars Wrigley plant. About to pick up a preloader trailer going to Hazleton, Pennsylvania. What I'm doing right now is finding me a spot to drop my empty, which he wanted me to drop it over here with the other primes, which I'm about to do now. Smell real good out here, like chocolate. Alright, we unhook this trailer, man. I'll get back with you. Alright, let's see what we got. Actually, I'm gonna need my gloves. Backed up under it, of course. It's already sitting a little high. Gotta lower it down a little bit. But what the hell else is new? Alright, but people, it is the first of the month, November 1st, about a quarter after 9 in the morning. I got here yesterday, dropped my load off next door at the Romark, grabbed me an empty, came right back over here and parked for the night, got me a pre-plan, picking up at a Cargill, it's only like 4 miles down the road, dropping hook. At the 01 and the 90 going to Wintersville, but I can't drop it till after midnight tonight, which is fine. It's gonna take me about 5 hours to get to Wintersville, and then find me somewhere to park, and I probably won't deliver this until early tomorrow morning, because if I get up tonight and then deliver it right at midnight or right after midnight, I probably won't have anywhere to park after that, and that's not going to be good. So it's got a window from midnight to 8 in the morning. So as long as I drop before 8 in the morning, I'll be fine. Right now, I just called.
You have 8 hours and 0 minutes of remaining drive time.
I just called Cargill. My load is ready, so I'm going to go ahead and get this ride out the way. Go across the street here and get a washout, too. Come on, man. Oh. But, yeah. I don't know what I'm going to end this video. I'm just been pulling out the phone randomly, just doing a little bit of updates here and there. But, we'll see. All right, everybody. We are here in Fletcher, North Carolina at the Sierra Nevada Brewing Company. Prime does a lot of business out of here. A lot of y'all Prime drivers know exactly what I'm talking about. But here picking up my load, going to Columbia, South Carolina. Funny thing is, I love coming to this place, man, because this load was scheduled to pick up for tomorrow between 8 and like 2. But as I was filling up my previous reefer with fuel, I went ahead and called, and they said, yeah, that was sitting on the yard ready to go. So, of course, I'm going to go ahead and come get it right now. I got my air going in my trailer. Go ahead and release that air, so I go ahead and slide the tandems where I need them to go. And then, with the last hour and a half of drive time that I got on my 70, I'm going to go as far as I can. And that'll be where I'll be at till in the morning. We'll finish the rest of the ride then. Alright, just seeing how heavy we are on the trailer real quick. You know, these alcohol loads, usually very, very heavy. They got an outgoing scale. Of course, I got to go across the scale before I leave, but you always want to make sure you got your tandems right before you even jump on the scale. So you don't have to worry about jumping on and off the scale multiple times trying to get your weights right. I've got tandems all the way back, I mean all the way up front. So, looks like we are right on 34,000 for the trailer. Might have to bring them up one hole just to be safe. So let's do that.
A new message has arrived.
I don't know if y'all can see that. Actually, over on our drives, we actually pretty light on our trailer, 32. So which means I just have to put the tandems back where they were. Wow. The trailer's not calibrated correctly, but you know. Well, actually it is. I just moved it up too far. I gotta move it back. All right, let's try this again. Tandems back to the original spot before I move them. All right, as you can see, we are legal now. 32.9,
33.6. Time to go. Got to live for today, cause tomorrow ain't promised to me. Don't just want a piece, I want my whole destiny. If you got it, I'm gonna take it. If you're in it, you're coming with me. Bench warmers, get no playing time. No sleeping till I cross the line. I'm running.